I'm Al John Goh, co-host of the Disney List podcast as heard on Sorcerer Radio, as well as Skull Rock podcast, here with my wife, Kristen. Hello.
Hello.
You are an earmarked agent who books Disney travel vacations for people all the time. Give our listeners a reason why they want to give you a call instead of just booking a trip by themselves.
Well, I can do all of the legwork for them. I have expertise. I've been to the Disney parks well over 100 times, so they've got that knowledge at their hand, as well as it saves them time and money.
Where can people get in touch with you so that they can book their next Disney cruise, Disney park trip, Adventures by Disney?
They can contact me at themeparksandcruises@gmail.com.
Skull Rock Podcast, talking all things Disney, with your hosts, Al John Goh and Dave Bossert.
Do you just love to learn more about the magic that embodies animated films, theme park attractions, and more? The all-encompassing universe created and produced by the genius of Walt Disney has spanned nearly 100 years and counting.
From his earliest film endeavors with the Laugh-O-Gram cartoons and the Alice comedies, to the creation of Mickey Mouse, to the first animated feature film, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, and then dreaming of Disneyland, Walt Disney continuously raised the creative bar, and today his company has carried on that tradition as a global entertainment juggernaut. I'm Dave Bossert, artist, filmmaker, and author.
And I'm Al John Goh, musician, podcaster, and radio guy. Every week, Dave and I will explore the entertainment galaxy that is Disney with insightful conversation, stories, and special guests talking all things Disney.
Listen to never-before-heard stories and behind-the-scenes moments from some of your favorite Disney films, theme park attractions, performances, books, music, and so much more from knowledgeable, insightful, and thought-provoking hosts and guests. Hear the latest news about Disney past, present, and future.
Skull Rock Podcast is your go-to source for the magic we all love. Skull Rock Podcast. Visit skullrockpodcast.com.
Do you want to be part of something bigger? At Siemens, we use AI to transform the everyday. Our engineering solutions drive innovation and change. We're leading in technology and building a sustainable future. Join Siemens and make an impact to transform the everyday. Apply now and be part of something extraordinary. Visit siemens.co.in/careers.
Dining at Disney Podcast. The Dining at Disney Podcast. You'll discover all the best restaurants and food as you wonderfully explore the Disney parks.
Let's do this thing!
The Dining at Disney Podcast. And now your hosts, Kristen and Bubba.
What is the one place we would choose to eat at each of the parks, whether it's counter service or table service? That's what we're talking about today. Welcome to the Dining at Disney podcast. I'm Kristen. With me is Bubba and Kat. How are you guys doing?
I have a headache. I don't know about you guys, but I got a major headache after today.
It's been a stressful day.
It's been a stressful day. It has been. So we're going to be talking about that, right? Yeah. Yes, we will.
So everybody's about to find out why Bubba and Kat have had a stressful, long day, and it is Disney related.
Oh, yeah.
But before we get into that, make sure if you haven't already, you like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you know when we share new content or we go live on Facebook like now. So, Bubba, what did you guys talk about last week?
I don't think we did more fun than talking. I mean, with Al John. So what did we talk about last week? I believe it was our top hidden spots.
Yes, right.
So it was our hidden spots that we'd like to, you know, people don't really know, yet they kind of know, kind of, but, you know, just spots that we like.
Yeah. Yes. Last week I had fun and fell down, a flight of stairs in my house. So luckily you can't see the bruise that's on my leg because it's enormous. It's huge. It looks like I was in a car accident if you look at my leg. That really deep, dark purple. So it's pretty. It just, it's, now I can, because it's like the back, like corner side position. So when I would sit in a hard chair, it hurt so bad. So I was sitting like this. So this chair, I couldn't sit in because it's a hard chair. So pretty much what I did is sit all week on the couch whenever I was sitting with my legs up and positioned in a way that there was no weight being put on that.
Yeah.
But my arm doesn't look too bad. It looks more like, if you look at my arm.
I see it though. Good Lord. Oh, my goodness.
It looks more like it's dirty.
Oh my gosh, you are so
okay.
Oh, yeah. Our stairs are hardwood, and I went down 7 of them. Okay, so let's start talking about why your day was stressful. Because I know everybody who's listening is like, okay, what Disney happened? That was stressful.
Well, I'm sure people know. I mean, because it's all over the internet, all over Twitter, all over Facebook. And it was just nuts. Today, tickets went on sale for A Touch of Disney, which is the event happening at California Adventure starting May 18th. So we don't know what time the tickets were supposed to go on sale. We've been questioning it all week. And finally, we got a tweet today at 9 a.m., saying tickets are now on sale for the Touch of Disney. So bam, I go directly to the queue that they have. So you have to go to the webpage. At the bottom, it said check ticket availability. Once you click that, they enter you in a queue. You know, same thing you do if you go to any like Comic Cons or anything like that. So they don't overload the system. D23, they have a queue for you to wait in. And I finally clicked on mine at 9 a.m. and it said I had over an hour wait for me to look. Now, I don't know what Kat had, what time she logged in.
About the same, but I've been dealing with a little insomnia lately. So I was on at midnight. I was on at 6.
Same here.
I was on like every hour looking.
Same here. I was on at midnight, checked 4 a.m. I woke up in the middle of the night. I checked 6 a.m. There was Funko Pops that were being released today. So I checked those out. And then I thought, check the Disney thing. And it wasn't up. So 7 wasn't up. So I go back to bed. I guess everybody goes back to bed. At 8 a.m., they started the queue at 8 a.m. So if you were to went to that page at 8 a.m., you would see check ticket availability, and it would enter you in the queue at 8 a.m. Nobody knew that, and yeah.
Don't you wish when Disney did those queues, they would be like, you are spot 2,961, and you would know where you fell in the queue?
For the D23, they did that. I don't know if you guys remember, but when we were trying to get like stage pass and store passes, you could see how many people were in front of you.
That I remember too.
Yeah, that's right. You could.
It's
huh?
Like that's how it is for Coachella. That's how it is for Comic Con. I don't know. I never got through. It was awful.
It was. But at around 9:20, you know, so I get in, not expecting how long I'm actually going to wait at 9 a.m. At around 9:20, I heard everybody got booted out of getting tickets, and you were also still in the line queue, but it said tickets are on pause. So we don't know what happened, if tickets sold out, the system crashed, and we were kind of in the air with that for about 20, 30 minutes maybe. And then around 10, the clock went back to where it said, you have more than an hour wait. I had a buddy who goes to Comic-Con and stuff. He knew that something was going to happen maybe earlier. So he got in at 8, and he actually got in the queue at 8 a.m. He was about to buy his tickets at 9:10, and he got booted out. He went back on after everything was up, and he had to wait for the hours again.
That's what happened to us with D23.
With D23.
And see, that's happened a lot with Disney, where I've been whether it be that or even calling Disney directly about something where you're on hold, like for free dining and I'm waiting to get in and somehow you get disconnected and then you have to call and you start all over again. Yes. And that's happened to me a couple of times. Now, I've been an agent now for 10 years. So, of course, it's not like that kind of stuff doesn't happen. But
oh, it does.
Luckily, it's only been twice, but it's so frustrating when you've been like on hold for 2 hours listening to the same soundtrack that Disney has had on its phone system now for the past 10 years. And you hear the audio that's like breaking up, it's like crackly, it needs to be replaced. And you can really only hear in a day, It's a Small World so many times before you're just like,
or Fantasmic.
I know I
played Fantasmic a lot too over that line.
Although you know when you're on hold for like 45 minutes and then the DuckTales theme song comes on and you're like, yeah. Yep,
that comes on too.
You know but speaking of DuckTales, I have to say this really quick and it's completely off topic. Those of you that have been listening for a while, you know I'm a hockey fan and I'm a season ticket holder for the Nashville Predators. But I will say that going back to when it was the Mighty Duck, Anaheim Mighty Ducks, when the Preds always play a song when they're announcing who the team opening roster is. And it's funny because they always play DuckTales. Even to this day, they still DuckTales when they're going through the list of who's going to be on the ice. And so
I don't find that insulting at all.
That song makes me so happy. It's so good.
Oh, I could play Darkwing Duck when I come out for any reason. I'll play it. So we're going about our day. Everybody's waiting and waiting. Don't know how long this more than hour is going to be. And, you know, I'm chatting with Kat also, you know, seeing how she's doing. She's in the same predicament as I am. I go to Twitter and I start seeing everybody's post about Touch of Disney, seeing that everybody has a wait. Some people actually are waiting minutes, 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes. But a lot of people are still waiting that hour. And then they started showing the days popping, what days were missing. So I was trying to let Kat know if she wanted to go a certain day. Luckily, that was one of the last days still available.
Wow. I didn't get it.
You didn't get it?
Oh, no.
Oh, shoot.
We ended up getting the 9th instead of the 2nd. So we got tickets, but it was a fluke. Like, I never got into the room at all. My buddy Steven, who I'm going with, just logged on randomly and he got right in.
That's what I heard too. Some people went. See, I logged in before my wife, yet she got in first.
Yeah.
And I
see that makes no sense at all. That tells you that queue is Disney needs to update its system.
My buddy was saying, why don't they use Comic-Con system? Comic-Con system seemed pretty flawless from what they say. But yeah, so officially I waited 5 hours and 10 minutes until I finally got my tickets. And we didn't get it for the 21st, which is Sunday. That was one of the first days sold out. But we did get it for the 22nd, which is a Monday the next day.
Nice.
See, so basically all the Mondays and Thursdays were
still there.
The last ones, you know, that were available. Yeah.
Yeah.
Except opening day, which 18th, I think that was the first Thursday that sold out first. But yeah, we got them. We're going.
Nice.
Yeah. But I'm like, I'm so tired. I'm not even enthused. I'm just like, yay, we got them.
Oh. Seriously. After 6 hours of fighting with it, I was just like, and we're done. Great.
And you just see this little Mickey head just going back and forth. I would take screenshots and Mickey would look like eyes closed or high. Just showing my screenshots. If you see them on Twitter, big_Bubba_B, that's how I was communicating today because that's where I was getting all my information from.
Oh my gosh.
People were posting seconds, like what days were left.
It looks like Michelle Murray in the chat says that as a 5:11, the queue is closed. So it looks like it's probably sold out all the way.
Yeah. It is sold out, yeah. Before we started the show, it was officially sold out.
That doesn't surprise me.
I'm guaranteeing you they're going to add more days after this.
100%.
That's another thing. They added another 2 weeks when the site crashed. When it popped back up giving updates, it said, due to its popularity, we're adding 2 more weeks.
Yeah.
So they added 2 weeks to that. So I'm guessing it's going to be more.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you guys see that Universal added one today too?
Yes, they did. Michelle was talking about that with me too.
That's cool though. I'm sure those tickets were easy to get.
It has been forever since I've been to that Universal. I mean, I've only been there once. And there's probably still in my parents' house, like the sweatshirt we bought or whatever. You know, but it was back in, let's see, 91.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
uh-huh. That's like before Jurassic Park. That's a long time ago.
That's Back to the Future, King Kong.
Yeah.
Earthquake.
Yes. Yes. You know what? I thought that was the coolest thing in the park when I went was that whole fake earthquake thing. And I remember the first time I went to Disney World, which was happened to be after that. And I was like, wait, this is like Universal. They had their kind of like their version of like the backstage thing. So. But yeah. I guess we should get into today's topic, huh?
Yeah, I need something else to talk about.
Yeah, something less stressful.
Yes.
Okay, so should we start with... as I hit the microphone. Let's start with Walt Disney World. And we'll do it like each person one at a time. And we'll do each of the parks, counter service, and then... the table service that we would select. And this was a question that came to us from Matt, right?
Matt.
Yeah, I think it was from Matt. I'm going to double check.
Check right now. Mike C.
Mike, okay.
Mike C.
I was thinking Matt C for some reason. Okay.
So Samsonite. I was way off.
Okay, so we're answering his question. It is from our Dining at Disney Facebook group. So that's where this question came from. So we'll start with Magic Kingdom. Kat, what is your place at Magic Kingdom? Or your places, I should say.
So I know this is an unpopular opinion, but I don't love the food at Magic Kingdom. It's not my favorite part to eat in. But if we're going to eat there, I usually tend to... want to snack more than anything else. My sit down is Jungle Skipper. Because of my allergies, I have a gluten allergy. So when we go, they have a lot of choices to eat. I don't love a theme park hamburger, which is a lot of what the choices are for gluten-free right now, unfortunately. So Jungle Skipper, they have a couple other things that I can choose from, which is great. And then quick service. Last week I talked about this. Was it last week? I think it was last week, maybe the week before, about how much I love a lobster roll.
Yes.
So I am going to go with Columbia Harbor House, but they're not open right now. So Cosmic Rays is my very close second. They have decent burgers and lots of space to sit inside so you can get some air conditioning, which is always good. On Magic Kingdom days, you do a lot of walking at the Magic Kingdom. So being inside and getting that air conditioning while you can enjoy your meal is priceless, in my opinion. So,
yeah. And I'm going to have to go with two different places from you. I'm going to go with, for my counter service, it's got to be Pecos Bills. And the reason being is that I like Mexican food and I love the toppings bar there, and you can get like nachos and you have your choice of like chicken, beef, and pork carnitas, so you have, you know, a variety of choices. I'm not a big hamburger eater, and so when I eat hamburgers, I'm very, very particular about them. Same. And the kind that you get at a quick service location is not my kind of burger. You know,
I'll agree with that.
Nice, good burgers. And you can't get that, you know, in the Disney parks. You can get it in Disney Springs, but not in the parks. So yeah. I had to go with Pecos Bills. They've got tons of things for the topping bar, so you can customize whatever you get. And they're large portions. So
they used to.
That I went with for that. And then one of my very favorite characters is Belle. And my favorite Disney movie is Beauty and the Beast. And I do like the food at Be Our Guest. I like the fact that if you're wanting a drink, they have drinks that are very specific to complementing the dish. It's not because of it used to being a dry park. You have French beers and French wines, and it's meant to go with the food. And I think that's nice. The restaurant is beautiful. And we haven't had a bad meal there.
That's good.
But I agree with you, Kat. Of the parks, that is my least favorite for food.
Which is unfortunate. Yeah. You know, like I'm cool with like getting snacks and like I can't have them, but people love the pizza, egg rolls or that kind of stuff. And I'm always down for a Dole Whip or like fresh fruit or veg or even just like a side of French fries from Casey's.
Or but a pickle. Like,
a big pickle. I'm always in for a pickle. But, you know, it feels like if I'm going to go to the Magic Kingdom, I'm going to be there. And then if I want to eat, I'll get on the monorail or I'll take a little walk to the Contemporary or I'll get on the monorail and go to Epcot and eat there or, you know, something about the Magic Kingdom. I go there for like the ambiance and the rides and see the characters, but like to eat frozen chicken nuggets is not like it's not my thing usually.
No. Yeah. I go to DCA for the liquor.
Yes.
Well, we will get that in a little bit. Bubba has not been to Walt Disney World yet.
No, I haven't.
Okay. Soon. Because when you go, we are going to have a great time.
I know I will. I'm going to be like a kid at a candy store, a kid at Disneyland. What do you know? I'll be like a kid at Disneyland.
Yay. Okay, so the next park is Epcot. I'm going to say for counter service, I'm going to go with Sunshine Seasons. And the reason being is there's such a wide variety because you have like your grill station, your sandwich station. They've got a station that has Asian food. So there's a lot of variety and it's typically available for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Yeah. And it's, you know, a lot of healthy choices too, and choices for people who have a lot of food sensitivity. There's something True. For everybody there. And mm-hmm. so I like that. And it's in a good location being in the Land Pavilion. And I think they have really good things overall for food. And I can always find something that I enjoy as well as whoever's with me. So that's why I had to pick that one. And I will say the hardest thing at this park is definitely picking a table service.
There's too many.
Yeah, there's so many good choices.
So many.
So this, I'm sure, is going to be surprising to a lot of people who don't listen to this or haven't been longtime listeners. And I have to go with a beer garden.
No way.
I am more German than anything else.
I am shocked.
Crazy.
I mean, my last name kind of gives that away a little bit. But so I grew up on some of the things that you find for the side dishes, like the sour creamed cucumbers or the cucumbers with the onion and tomato, and it has the vinegar dressing with it. Mm-hmm. All of those things I never knew were German dishes because they were just kind of like things that were made. You know, yeah. I knew that
that's,
German
that's
potato
very
salad.
Vibrant. For being German, that's very vibrant, all those.
Oh, yeah. those are things that I grew up on being pretty, you know, staple things to eat around the house. And so I like those things. And then you have like the spot in. And I'm going to tell you, strangely enough, the best soups, Beer Garden has the best soups. They have this amazing wild mushroom soup. It's really good. They have a great potato leek as well as a great tomato soup. And you get these little, instead of being the normal pretzel shapes, they're just like these pretzel sticks that you can dip in your, you know, use to dip in your soup. Things like that. I mean, it's just, I like the fact that they also have a carving station. So there's somebody there to cut that. There's traditional dishes. I don't know if anymore, but for the longest time, they had German chefs running the restaurant. So you were getting, I remember when the restaurant was just okay many years ago, but at one point it was Chef Jens Dahlman who had become the executive chef of Epcot and then went off somewhere else. But when he took control of that, the whole place changed and became so much better. It's fun. It's great if you have kids because they can get up and dance and sing along and all that kind of fun stuff. So it's good entertainment for that. And I also enjoy being seated with people I don't know, where you get to, you know, hopefully we've only, as the many times that we've been, we've only once had a couple that was not friendly, but the family on the other side was. But for the most part, you meet all kinds of new people and you find out, oh my gosh, we live in the same city. And oh gosh, you know, that's where I grew up. And hey, did you know this person? I mean, some of the stories I've had over the years from people, it's crazy to know that we're from two different states, yet we know some of the same people, that's, you know, so that cool kind of stuff. So,
yeah.
But so that's why I had to go with Beer Garden, but it was very a difficult decision. How about you, Kat? What are your two places? I think I know what one of them is.
Probably.
My sit down, hands down, is Rose and Crown.
Nice rhyme right there.
Hey, I love it. They do gluten-free fish and chips, which I love. They also do like a butter chicken curry, Indian style, which is always good. Cheese plate, good salads, good drinks. Ambiance is great. I have a very deep affinity for English culture. I've always been like that. If anybody follows me on Instagram, when I was home for Christmas this year, I did like a tour of my childhood bedroom. And when I was in high school, I was obsessed with going to England. So my childhood bedroom is painted like an old English pub because I'm crazy. And I just love it. I don't know what it is about the ambiance or just about like the idea of like British culture. I love it. So Rose and Crown, hands down, no matter what. We always
not what I thought you were going to say.
Really?
Yes, I thought you were going to say Takumi Thai.
You know, we've only done that one time, and I really enjoyed it, but it's so expensive.
Yeah.
It's so expensive. So that's not my top pick. That's not my top pick.
Okay.
I do, for quick service, love the Kabuki Cafe.
Oh, yeah.
You can get a little like, serving of sushi. They serve the frozen Kirin. They serve the sake mist, which is like the shave ice with sake in it, which is really
I have
good.
Not tried that. I always get it with the sweetened condensed milk.
Oh, that's good
too. That it, I,
right? Shave, yeah. Yeah, the snow cap. I will eat shave ice every day of the week. You can ask mom. She'd tell the same thing.
I love that.
But my like choice quick service for Epcot is the Cantina de San Angel. In Mexico, because mm-hmm. the portions are big, you can share them. Their nachos are so good. The guac with chicharrón are delicious. I just like, that's why I didn't pick Pecos Bill for Magic Kingdom, because I think I'm going to say Mexican food for like every other park. So I knew you'd pick Pecos Bill, and I was like, can I just say that I eat nachos a lot? Like, that's weird.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with that.
But yeah, okay. There's so many choices at Epcot. Like, there's so many. There's something for everyone at Epcot, which I love.
Well, the thing is I could name at Epcot maybe not five counter service. Actually, I could if I include like you know, getting kakigori and those kind of like the more carts rather than so much a restaurant.
Restaurant, exactly.
But table service, I could easily come up with five.
Seriously, like it's all great. It's all great. And now that it's like a festival every single day of the year at Epcot, there's so much food, it's overwhelming.
Oh, I know. So at Hollywood Studios,
I'm a broken record about Hollywood Studios. Brown Derby Lounge is my jam. Brown Derby Lounge with Orlando and Danielle, and I could hang out there all day and eat Cobb salad and drink Bloody Marys until, you know, I was on the floor and they'd have to carry me home. That's fine. I'm fine with it.
Nice.
My quick service choice is a commissary, which is just another, they're serving like tacos, carnitas salad with carnitas and carnitas tacos there right now. So it's just more delicious Mexican street food, which I love. So commissary, their menu changes a lot. That's where they like test things. I feel like, but every time, even when they switch stuff up, it's always good. And
I had
tucked in a corner. So
yeah, I had bad experiences there for a while. And so it
really
Oh yeah. So it became I'm not going to eat there because I like feeling good all day.
Yep.
Nope, so I get it. I avoided ABC commissary for a long time, but their new menu definitely makes me want to go there.
Yeah.
But my place is going to have to be, oh my gosh, it's just Baseline Tap.
Sure.
And I know it's more of like a snack place than a place you're going to go and have a meal, because it's, you know, charcuterie and pretzels, but the beers are really good. And I just kind of like, in that part, there's not a counter service place that I'm like, really like, oh, I have to go there. And it was kind of between that and Woody's Lunchbox.
Oh,
because I found the food at Woody's Lunchbox to be really good, but it's so hard to get a table.
Yeah, that area is really cramped.
Yeah, it is. So that's why I had to go with that. And then I'm with you, Hollywood Brown Derby. You can't go wrong either in the restaurant or at the lounge. Just the food is so good. And it really depends, like, whether you have, could you get a reservation? And are you looking for drinks? Like to really sit there and drink and kind of more nibble of which place you go with. Because I mean, the food comes from the same restaurant.
Exactly.
But I always have a good experience when I'm there. And like you said, Cobb salad is amazing.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Oh man. What about Animal Kingdom?
I am going to say for my counter service, I'm going with Flame Tree Barbecue. I love the onion rings, and I'm addicted to their spicy barbecue sauce there. For a while, they didn't have it, and I was very, very sad about that. And so it kind of became not a must do. But now that the barbecue sauce has been back for the past few years, that, and I like their baked beans there. So the meats are always good, but I'm more of at Animal Kingdom, I always seem to get hot easily when I'm there. And so I'm a very light eater usually in that park. So I just want something to like just snack on. So I'm not hungry, but I don't want to be full, because then I just feel like, ugh. You know, you just feel really very drained.
Yeah.
But my go-to place, and this may not be surprising because I've mentioned this many times, is Yak and Yeti, because they have the best ahi tuna nachos. They are one of the best nachos just overall of places. They're so good with that tuna and then the spicy sauce that's drizzled on it. Like, And it's not made with tortilla chips. It's the fried wontons. It's unique. And everything else on the menu is good that I've had there. And they usually do specials. So that's another good thing, is there's usually a couple of things that aren't already on the menu. And they usually end up being something they're testing out, because we've seen some of those items end up being permanently added to the menu. So that's cool. And if you have a Landry's card and you don't have a reservation, you still get the next table available. So that's a good thing, that if you couldn't get a reservation for any place and you want sit down, you can get the sit down.
That's awesome.
How about you, Kat?
My sit down is going to be Nomad Lounge. Everyone knows I'm a Joe Rohde stan, so I gotta hit the Nomad Lounge, get a little Jen's tattoo with the pickled hibiscus. It's like a tuna rice bowl with edamame and pickled cucumber, and
yeah,
I'm into it every time. It doesn't matter. I always want to go in there. The decor is amazing. The staff is so nice, and I just love it.
See, you know what would be dangerous, Kat, is if you were not gluten-free, because you and I like a lot of the same, similar
flavors
and stuff like that, that we could absolutely share so many meals. We would just, oh gosh, it would be dangerous.
Yeah, it would be dangerous, for sure, for sure.
It'd be bad. We'd order so much food.
Oh, I mean, that's what we do. It's like four things and then we share them. And I just,
yeah,
I want one of everything. That's my motto, one of everything. And then my quick service, I tend to go to Animal Kingdom early. I like going there before it gets really hot. I like doing the safari early in the morning. So I tend to not eat like full meals there. Usually we hit Nomad on our way out. But I really love the Royal Anandapur tea cart in Asia. They have so many different choices of teas and coffees, hot, iced, blended. They do mixed drinks. And then they have pastries, the big donuts, which I can't eat any of that stuff, but I know it appeals to a lot of people. But I'm addicted to tea. I drink so much tea. So going there, if it's like chilly out, the hot tea is good. If it's hot out, the iced tea is great. It's all Joffrey's products, so you really can't go wrong. And when it's early, like, I don't need to eat a cheeseburger I don't need any of that stuff. Usually I'm like a banana and go kind of person in the morning.
Yeah.
So just going and being able to have that cup of tea that I'm accustomed to in the morning is so nice. And the ambience over there is so nice. You can like sit and look at the water. And now that they're doing the boat cavalcades with the characters, you can just like sit there and wave at Chip and Dale or whatever. And it's just really nice and sweet and cozy and quiet, which is really what I go to Animal Kingdom for, just to like be in the green spaces and enjoy like nature noises in the morning. Yeah. It's fantastic.
Oh, I absolutely agree. It was one of my favorite parks when Al John used to work and have Florida as his territory. It was one of my favorite parks to go to because so many people don't like Animal Kingdom. They think it's just boring and too hot. But I could go and I would spend like an hour watching all the birds fly around, or go
so
over
peaceful.
To Maharaja track and sit there for like a good 30 minutes or so, just watching the tigers roam around, you know, that kind of stuff. So
yeah,
I agree. Okay, now we're on to Bubba's Parks.
Oh!
We didn't forget about you, Bubba.
We didn't forget about Bubba.
I enjoyed listening to all those suggestions right there. Those were awesome.
Okay, so let's start with you at Disneyland.
Disneyland, geez. I'm going to be a broken record here, too. So table service has to be Carnation Cafe for me. It's just wonderful spot to be in. You know, if you want to enjoy the ambiance of Disneyland, it's right there in the middle of Main Street. They have everything, breakfast, lunch, dinner, a snack. You know, you just don't have to go and eat a meal. You can have a bowl of soup. You can have a cinnamon roll. You can have a cappuccino now or coffee and just enjoy the ambiance right there. But it's always great food over there. It's always great service over there. And I miss seeing Chef Oscar every morning, having breakfast with him, him coming by, talking Disney history and how I think of the food and stuff like that. So it's always good to just be there, even if I'm not eating, just, you know, just being right there just always fills me with joy because I love that spot. So sit down, that has to be my number one spot in Disneyland. Or quick service, I'm kind of up in the air with this, but here we go with the broken record again. Rancho del Zocalo. I mean, you're going Mexican food, I got to go with this spot. Not just because of the food, just also because of where it is. I like hearing the whistle of the Mark Twain. I like hearing the train from Thunder Mountain come by. And then it's also a good people-watching spot because it's a high-traffic area, which is something me and Taylor love to do also. And it's a good meetup spot, too, if you ever meet up with friends or anything like that. It's just right there in the middle of a it's in the middle of all that. You know, you got Haunted Mansion right there, just above. You got Thunder Mountain and Star Wars Land right there. So it's the food is always amazing. Kristen, you know it. Kat, I don't know if I've eaten with you there yet. I'm sure you've eaten there, but
definitely.
Man, it's just great food. Always great food.
How about you, Kat?
Those are my two picks.
Hey!
I feel the same way. I'm gonna give an honorary mention to Jolly Holiday. I love Jolly Holiday grilled cheese and tomato soup.
Yep.
Again, with my tea fix at Jolly Holiday, they always have the best stuff. But I gotta agree with Bubba, hands down. I don't love to do a sit down meal at Disneyland, but if I'm going to, it's gonna be at Carnation Cafe. And Ranch, like I said, I love nachos. I just do. I don't know what it is about a tortilla chip, but like, even I'm at my house right now and I have like 4 bags of tortilla chips here in my house. So I love it. I don't know. It's easy. I know it's not going to make me sick. I know I can have it. There's no allergy issues. I'm in 100%.
Yeah.
So I am also going with Rancho del Zocalo.
We should have talked about this before.
No, it's better this way. This is why we all get along so well. This is the better way.
Even before any of us met, my first trip, when it was to Disneyland, and Al John and I went, we ate there, and I was like, this food is great. And of course, I've tried the other places, but there's just something about the food there. It's always great. I am picky also about my steaks. Those are my two things. There's something about beef I'm just picky about. It has to be done just right. And I don't like chewy steak. I can't do it. Their carne asada.
They cook it in front of you.
Perfectly.
So good.
I was so happy. And if it weren't for Taylor telling me how good it was, I wouldn't have ever tried it. But I always get that with the enchilada. And I'm with you, Kat. There's like 3 bags of the lime flavored tortilla chips.
You and
there's like the white queso and a couple things of salsa, as well as salsa that I made. I made a roasted habanero salsa.
Ooh.
Taylor, as we speak, is at a Mexican restaurant with her mom and bringing me home Mexican food. So
nice.
I will be enjoying that.
Amazing. 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 You know what else I love about Rancho del Zocalo is when they have seasonal specials.
Yes.
Yeah. They had the best Halloween special this, not this year, obviously, but the year before when Halloween was actually open. They had a really good taco that was delicious. They always have the frozen horchata and abuelita hot chocolate mixed together at the holidays.
And they have the blue corn tamales also. I don't know if they still have those. And then they have a hidden menu too. The Zocalo burrito, which has steak, pork and chicken in it with 3 sauces on top. It's just,
all of it.
That's one of their hidden menu items.
Oh, I love it.
Amazing. Yeah.
just do an episode about that. That's it. Yeah.
Well, I talk about Rancho del Zocalo, I mean, constantly on the show.
I know, me too.
It is an amazing place to eat and just hang out. Yeah.
It's got a cool atmosphere because you can either sit in a covered area or, you know, when the weather's nice, which it usually is when I'm there at least. Not always, because I was there when they had to close the park down because it flooded.
It flooded. I'm about to say, you were with us the day. I've been to the park twice where they've had to close early, and they've only closed early twice in the past 5 years. And I was there both days. I mean, maybe more. Oh, I think. And yeah, Kristen was there with us. Where
we have a picture of you and I together.
Yeah, we're just drenched.
Yep.
I have a picture of a cast member squeegeeing the streets of DCA all the water into the sewer because it was flooding so much. So I remember that day. That was fun.
But yes, it has a beautiful place to sit outside, especially at night with the lights and everything out there. It's just really like cool and relaxing.
Yeah. And you can listen to Fantasmic too as it goes on at night.
Yeah. And then I'm going to go with a different place, which I surprised Al John on that because we were talking about right before we hopped on the show. And I was telling him, because he was like, oh, you're going to go with Carnation Cafe. And I was like, actually, today I'm not. I'm going to go with Cafe Orlean.
Oh, that was my second right there.
That's a good one, too.
It's all, those are my two places, Carnation and that. And today I'm going with that because I've been craving just really flavorful, bold flavored food. And you know, you can't beat like Cajun and Creole food to get those big, bold flavors. And the Monte Cristo is always good. And there is something amazing about hot, fresh beignets with their powdered sugar and the berry dipping sauce.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to go. That's where I had to be different.
No, and I love the atmosphere right there, too. You got, like, the Orleans atmosphere, the jazz music playing. It's mm-hmm. another good spot to sit in while Fantasmic's going on if you want to listen to it. And the palm frites are just amazing. Oh.
You know what's really funny? I've been there either 4 or 5 times now, and only one of those times did I sit at a different table. So the table that we were at, Bubba, last time, that's always the table I'm sitting at, right by the door.
We've sat there a few times too.
Uh-huh. Every time I've been there with you, the only time I didn't get seated there was when I was there with Raphael and his girlfriend Jennifer when they were visiting from Florida.
Yeah, well, I've only sat outside maybe twice, but most of the time I'm inside.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't ask for it, but you know, it just happens.
Yeah.
Either way. So, okay, Bubba, you were mouthing Blue Bayou.
Do
you
I like thought she was going to say Blue Bayou for a second.
Yeah, I had a bad experience at Blue Bayou.
Me too. So
me three. Stop it. Which I talked about. Taylor, one of the servers moved too quickly with the serving tray and ranch came off and spilled on Taylor.
We ended up
getting like a certificate for socks and other stuff like that. Yeah.
That's
so
right.
I mean, and the food, it's okay. I mean, I always get the surf and turf, so can't go wrong with that. But the atmosphere is, I love it. I love the atmosphere. You can't beat that.
Oh, yeah.
That out of hands down, the best atmosphere anywhere in the park.
Yeah.
Unless you're in Club 33.
No, I had a waiter get really aggressive with me at Blue Bayou.
Really?
Like one of the only times I got. Yeah, he like smacked me with a pen and like it just was really aggressive and like putting me off eating there. I was like, what is happening? All my friends, I was there with like 5 people, and all my friends were like, what is going on? And I was
what
like,
what is with you and these trippy experiences? Because
if it's weird, if it's weird, it has happened to me. I guarantee it. Dude, we've had like people at the Italian restaurant talk shit about us. And my mom, talk crap about us. And my mom speaks fluent Italian, and they were like talking bad about us. And my mom was like,
oh,
are you serious? Like,
I speak Italian.
Hello.
Wow.
It, like, weird. The weirdest stuff happens to me. The weirdest stuff.
Not me.
Pardon my French. I'm sorry about that. You know I have a sailor's mouth.
I will say, Italian is one of the two languages that I wish that I could speak fluently. And what's funny is I took 2 years of Spanish, two different dialects. So it was very, very difficult, and decided I'm done with this foreign language. Like, no. But I find it easier to speak Italian than Spanish. Mainly yeah. because I cannot roll my R's to save my life.
Oh, me either.
And Italian is very much, I'm a talk with my hands person. So even though that's completely not a German thing and unusual, that's the one thing in Italy I can totally get behind. And I love to sit and watch Italians talk back and forth. It's just to see the discussion. Is just a cool thing, you know?
Welcome to my family.
So what was your bad experience at Blue Bayou then, Kristen? I'm trying to remember.
My appetizer as well as my entree came out cold. And instead of bringing me like a new one or saying, I'm so sorry, you know, it's been sitting here all day and it's not the right temperature. You know, can I get you something else? They put it in the microwave and brought it back. And so the jambalaya was so dried out because, I mean, it came cold, not just kind of cold, but like cold enough. It had been sitting on that plate probably for a couple hours, kind of cold.
Really?
And wow. Heated it up in a microwave instead of bringing you, like, let me get you a new one. And I was like, okay, I'm not impressed by this.
Wow.
Yeah.
What a bonding moment. We all three had bad experiences at Blue Bayou.
And we all three had great experiences at Rancho del Zocalo.
Yes, we have. Oh, the best.
Perfect. It's not a fluke. It's real.
So, California Adventure.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead, Kat, if you want. I mean, there's not many sit-down restaurants in California Adventure, but so...
Go ahead.
No, go ahead. No, you're for you.
I'm always going to pick Carpe Circle when it comes to DCA, always. I love sitting in there. I love the ambiance in there. Maggie, one of the bartenders, is a good friend of mine, and I just like to sit in there and chill and chat with her and, you know, have a few drinks, have some yummy food. I'm really excited to try this alfresco menu that they have for the Touch of Disney event. It looks incredible. I've never had a bad experience there, which is great. And then my quick service is, I picked Smoke Jumpers, but I don't love a lot of quick service over there. It's hard to pick the one that I like.
Yeah.
But I do like Smoke Jumpers. I don't know if they'll have it anymore, but I liked to go in there and just get like a handful of pickles and then walk out and eat them.
Yeah. That's one thing about Smoke Jumpers, girl. And I've told everybody this type of hack. If you know, they'll let you bring in like lunch meat and you can buy bread at Pacific Wharf. Then you go over to Smoke Jumpers and top your sandwich with whatever you want because they have a toppings bar that you can basically access at any time. And I mean, it's, yeah, the pickles, lettuce, tomatoes, onions, sauces, you name it, they had it.
Yep.
So, yeah, Smoke Jumpers, I do like. That came in kind of close with me just because also they have the frozen Jack and Coke, which is amazing on a hot day.
Oh, I haven't had that. That sounds delicious.
Is so good on a hot day. Just having that during the summer, I could have like 10 of those and be so happy. But I'm going with Flo's just because they are in a nice spot for, you know, checking out the scenes, going down Cars Land. You're right there by Radiator Springs, hearing the roar of the engine as they drive by. But their menu during breakfast and lunch. I've mainly been there for breakfast. I've been there for dinner a couple times, but breakfast is always my go-to place when it when it comes to DCA. And Flo's has, they have brioche French toast. They have chicken tamales for breakfast. They have the All-American too, like the Chef Oscar. And then the dinner menu is just the same. Not just the same, but just as good. They have a like Coca-Cola infused beef, I believe. I don't see it anymore on this menu though. They might have pulled it. But yeah, they got the pot pie, fried chicken, and their burger is actually pretty good, though. I know we talked about cheeseburger quick service. Smoke Jumpers and Flo's cheeseburgers are by far way better than any of Disneyland's if you go to
quick service. I agree. Yeah. I don't, because you know, even the cheeseburgers like from Magic Kingdom to Hollywood Studios, there's a difference. Yeah. I don't know what it is about Magic Kingdom cheeseburgers. They're just like, they don't cut it.
Well, same at Disneyland when you go to Tomorrowland Terrace over there. I mean, just the burgers just aren't that spectacular at all. It's just like, here's a burger at Smoke Jumpers and at Flo's, they actually care for their burgers. So, and their burgers are really good. At Smoke Jumpers, the burgers are really good.
I agree. Yeah.
What's your table service?
Oh, same Carte Circle. Just because, sorry, it's just, we went opening day, the first day it was open, and I fell in love with the food. I had the Angus burger, one of the best burgers I've ever had. I mean, every single bite to the last one, there was, dripping. It was just dripping with, juice. It was so juicy, so plump. And having the biscuits too before, it kind of fills you up, those like jalapeno cheddar biscuits. And it's Carthage. And I like the environment too, right there. You could sit outside, but inside it's just as spectacular. All the pictures you see around the restaurant, all the little private rooms they have. And of course, eating outside when, at nighttime, if you're lucky, you get to face the fireworks and have a nice dinner right there, and you get a front row view of the fireworks from Disneyland.
So I am going to agree with both of you on the sit down place. I'm gonna go with, for table service, Carte Circle. Like you mentioned, Bubba, it's really cool how they have those separate rooms in the theming. I like that whole turn of the century 20s theming that they have on Buena Vista. And so that being throughout that restaurant and the pictures of Walt throughout the years and stuff like that, you can't beat it. It's the coolest in that park, hands down. And the food's always really good. So, and they have amazing cocktails.
Oh, yes.
Definitely. Amazing cocktail.
Oh, yes.
So I have to go with that. And it's kind of hard with, I feel like, when it comes to the quick service locations. And the reason being is there's not one that, like, I find multiple things on the menu or, like, the entire menu is just great. I kind of, at that park, depends on my what I feel like that day. But I think I'm going to go with Award Wieners. I like the fact that they change out those hot dogs and that you have such a variety of toppings, and they're good size hot dogs. So it's not like you're going to leave hungry. Aljon and I've even before gone and been like, we're hungry, but we're not starving. So let's get a hot dog and, cut it in half. And, that's probably the size of a hot dog if you're eating hot dogs at home, eating half of that, because they put so many toppings and stuff on it too. So that's why
they
I had to pick
French
that.
Fries there.
Yes, they do.
Yeah, they do.
The film strip fries, those are good.
That's another thing I'm picky about, my French fries.
You put a potato in a fryer, I'll eat it.
I think that's most people.
You put a potato in anything, I'll eat it.
Go ahead. Fried potato anywhere, however, I'll take it.
Done and done.
Even the 5-second rule don't matter to that.
Well, I think that covers everything, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What a fun chat we had.
I agree.
It looks like in the chat, Michelle Murray agrees with you about Cafe Orleans.
For some reason, the chat froze up on my screen.
You can't see it? Okay, I'll do it.
Oh, we got it too,
she likes Tutto Italia at Epcot. sure, yes, love, yes. And Lindsay Marie likes Germany as well, Kristen.
Kate has reservations for Topolino's.
Oh.
Oh, nice. That's our I haven't either because, well, 2020 to the watch. So since that was the no park year, I haven't been there yet, but it's definitely a on my list of places to try because I've heard fantastic things about it.
Their character breakfast looks so cute. It's like they serve you like a thing full of things and then their characters come out in their little stupid outfits. That's
cute. So is that a good
Michelle got tickets to see to Taste of Universal. I'm probably not. Bub, are you going to do that one?
No, probably not. I doubt it.
I probably won't do it either. I'm looking forward to see what people say, but I'm good. But yeah, that looks like. Oh, what is Traber's baked potatoes?
Oh, Troubadour. I think Troubadour's baked potatoes. Yes, they're over by off the page, or that show.
Yeah.
In Disneyland.
Oh, right I don't there. Think I've ever
seen oh, their that. Baked potatoes are amazing.
Really?
Yeah, you definitely got to try one. Yes.
I do love a good baked potato.
Yeah, they got real
since
giant,
we're talking about
giant ones right there. I believe they have one with lobster in it.
I'm in.
I'm trying to remember their menu. So, but yeah, baked potatoes are definitely great. I buy the Troubadour. Yeah.
I'm in.
Gosh, so, I don't even remember what I had the last time I was there.
At Disneyland?
Yeah, over at Troubadour. I don't remember what I had.
Troubadour. Did you have a potato with this? I can't remember. I know I've had a few.
I don't think I did. And I ate there with Michelle. And it's when I'm trying to think of what the show was that was playing there.
Wasn't it Off the Page or whatever?
Maybe the
Mickey and the Magical Map. Thank you. Yeah.
Magical Map. Yep. When that first kicked off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm pulling up the Troubadour's menu right here. If you want to quick, you know, since Michelle mentioned that is definitely one of my favorite spots too. They have a bratwurst sausage. Yes. A bacon, sour cream, potato, broccoli, and cheese. That one's amazing. And I've had the barbecue chicken stuffed potato too. And that's, I think that lobster one was like a limited time one. If I remember, I don't see it on the menu, but.
Well, they used to have baked potatoes at,
Arbor Galley.
Yeah.
They used long time ago too. Yes.
Yeah. Before they switched all mac and cheese or whatever. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I remember.
Love it.
Any last places we need to mention or any additional comments?
Oh, I can't think of any more. I mean, yeah.
Okay.
I can't think of anything more.
Well, we hope you guys have enjoyed today's show. If you haven't already, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you know when we share new content. If you are looking to find the podcast, you can do that on Anchor or any of your favorite podcasting platforms such as Spotify, iHeartRadio, Apple Podcasts. And if you're looking to support the show, you can do so and be like our top supporter, Lindsay Marie. You can donate as little as 99 cents a month or as much as $9.99 a month. Or if you don't want to pay anything out of pocket, you can always support us by shopping our Amazon and Disney store link. And we get a little kickback from that when you do so.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Is it my turn? I can't tell.
It's their turn.
All right. You can find me, Bubba, on Instagram, Twitter now, because I did a lot of Twittering today at @big_Twittering. Is that what you call it?
Twittering. Yes, it is now.
I did a lot of Twittering today.
Oh, my gosh, Bubba.
@big_Bubba_B. And then you can also find us at the Dining at Disney Facebook page, diningatdisney.com, all of our social media accounts, Twittering, Facebooking, Instagramming, YouTubing, you name it, we're there. And then for all your Disney, Universal, and cruise travel I do have a little bit of alcohol in this cup. So, you can contact Kristen right here at themeparksandcruises@gmail.com. Get your quote, get your book today. And then where can everybody find you, Kat?
Oh, you can find me on Instagram at catastrophe, CAT_ASTROPHE, or at my podcast at Eat the Pictures, or www.eatthepicturespodcast.com. New episodes every Tuesday. And make sure to check out the Disney List every Sunday live on Facebook with Christian and Aljon. Also catch our friends WDW Park Hoppers, Park Hopper John and Park Hopper Sid talk about everything Walt Disney World on their podcast, and the Disney Parks podcast with Tony and John talking all things Disney Parks. Also for Facebook fun, check out the Disney Dorks and the Sorcerer Radio Fun Zone.
Until next time, guys, I'm Kristen. With me was Bubba and Kat. Bon appetit.
This podcast is not affiliated with the Walt Disney Company or its holdings and is intended for entertainment purposes.
I'm Kristen Hetzel, vacation planner, world traveler, Disney foodie, and theme park fan.
I'm Aljon Goh. I'm the husband who's also Disney, Star Wars, and Marvel Comics fan. And together, we host a Disney List podcast.
Every week, you'll hear us list our favorite things about Disney theme parks, films, shows, travel, Marvel, and Star Wars in a top 10 list, rankings, and more.
That's an impressive list. Subscribe to the Disney List podcast on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, or your favorite podcast platform. Even stream us on Sorcerer Radio at srsounds.com and check out our live shows on Facebook. The Disney List Podcast. Visit thedisneylist.com.